let's take a look at the Ottawa Senators and a busy offseason so far for them as they named DJ Smith their 14th head coach in franchise history. And then about a week later, they re-signed Anders Nielsen. Skip ahead to June 17th. They re-signed Anthony Duclair, who has been a nice fit so far up in Ottawa. And then as the free agent market opened, they made a bunch of moves. A six-player trade with the Maple Leafs. The notable names here, Connor Brown, Cody Ceci, Nikita Zaitsev, swapping teams. Also, they signed free agents Ron Hainsey and Tyler Ennis. And then on July 17th, they acquired Artem Anisimov from the Blackhawks for Zach Smith. Skip ahead to July 30th, and they acquired Ryan Callahan and a 2020 fifth-round pick from the Bolts in exchange for Mike Condon and a sixth-round pick in the upcoming draft as well. A lot of moves and a lot of question marks. Why would you make a trade for a Ryan Callahan, per se, who's on long-term IR? Can you break down exactly kind of what the Senators are thinking here?
Well, what they're thinking is they have the cap room to acquire players like that. They have the room to have them on the roster, and then they can get an asset from the Tampa Bay Lightning in return. So they ended up moving up around in picks there, and they also were able to move Mike Condon off their roster as well. They feel like they're going in a different direction with their goaltending. So that's what it really enables them to do, and that's what teams do when they're rebuilding and they don't want to, they know they're going to really only be looking to spend to the floor or a little above it. So they have some room to make things happen, to gain more assets to help them in their rebuild, and it's pretty straightforward. And for Tampa, you know, it helps them because obviously they're in a position where they need all the cap room they can get. They move Ryan Callahan off. They don't have to wait until they have to go through the long-term injury process. So that's what's going on with the Ottawa Senators. And they are in full, complete rebuild at this point.
What is the timetable for that rebuild? Is this a team? I mean, they were in the Eastern Conference Final 3 years ago, 4 years ago, very recently.
Yeah.
And my, how they have fallen since then. So what's a realistic timeline for them to get back into the playoffs?
Yeah, just 3 years ago, double overtime loss to the Pittsburgh Penguins, Game 7. They could have been in the Stanley Cup Final. It went downhill from there. You know, they have a lot of things going on within their organization. Their owner, Eugene Melnyk, is trying to figure out ways to get a new building in the downtown area of Ottawa that's been going on for now for several years. So I think that has been kind of the holdup financially for the organization in some way. They've decided to kind of tear it down. Carlson wanted out. Stone wanted out. They moved those guys out. They brought in younger assets. They've got a lot of talented young players within this group. When you think about Brady Tkachuk as one guy, Thomas Chabot as another guy. They got Erik Brännström from the Vegas Golden Knights in the Mark Stone deal. Mm-hmm. So they've got a lot of talented young guys within their group. They've got a lot of picks and prospects that they have a chance to develop moving forward. But it's going to take time. And that's why they went out this year and they've added a couple of veteran players. They want Anisimov in from the Chicago Blackhawks. They've got the players they acquired from the Toronto Maple Leafs. It's kind of interesting with that rivalry between the Senators and the Leafs. And now the Senators have a number of players that just played on the Toronto Maple Leafs last year when you think of Zaitsev and Hainsey really right off the top. So I think what they're trying to do is develop these young guys, have some older players there that have some experience like a Hainsey to help with the development of a Chabot and a Brännström if he jumps in there this year, and try to take that long-term approach. DJ Smith comes in as the head coach there. It's his first NHL head coaching job. He has been on Mike Babcock's bench in, interestingly enough, Toronto for the last couple of years as an assistant coach. He won at the junior level. He brings in a couple former NHL head coaches in Davis Payne and Jack Capuano to round out his coaching staff. So it's going to be an interesting year with the Ottawa Senators. I would say simply this in their locker room, that everyone outside of Ottawa will be saying, well, this is a rebuild. These guys have no chance. In that room, DJ Smith and those veteran players will be selling the idea of, hey, it's us against the world. Yep. Nobody thinks we're any good. Let's go out and find a way to be competitive. And I think because they have talented young players there, they have a chance to be competitive on a night-to-night basis. I just don't think they have enough to sustain it over an 82-game season. So I'll be watching to see the development of those young guys, and that's the key for the Senators this year, the continued development of the Tkachuks and of the Chabots and those type of players.
Well, you think about a team like Colorado, for example. They were supposed to be in a full rebuild, and then what did they do? They went and made the playoffs. Now people are talking about them as one of the most exciting teams going forward in the near future. So can Ottawa, I don't know, look at their draft picks or look at their young guys and expect maybe a bit of a surprise this year?
Well, I don't know if it'll be a surprise this year. But I do think, you know, this is a team that has some really good young players. Now, when you mentioned Colorado, they had a McKinnon already there.
Sure.
They had, you know, a Rantanen, and they had some high-end players. They had a down year, and then it kind of turned back up again. I think it'll take longer for the Ottawa Senators to figure that out. But they have the base of something special there. I mean, Brady Tkachuk is a competitive son of a gun that's going to be a leader for that franchise. Again, Shabbat is a really, really high-end defenseman. Brännström is a really good, young, talented defenseman that really was high on Vegas's list, and they had to move him to get a player like Stone. So there's some good, really, some really talented guys to build around. They have the old veteran goalie, Craig Anderson. The one thing that's remained the same is Craig Anderson is still there in goal. If Craig Anderson can give them good goaltending night after night, if DJ Smith can put a system in place where they are better defensively, because that's the problem with young players, and particularly young defensemen, is that you are going to have sloppy play in your own end. So if they can kind of shut things down a little bit defensively in their own end, be clean that up a little bit, Craig Anderson can give them some solid goaltending. Then they're in the games night after night. But again, the bigger picture for the Senators is continue to develop those young players, draft the good ones when you have those draft picks coming up in the coming years, and really aim for 2, 3, 4 years down the road.
All right. Sounds like a good plan, but I'm going to go out on a limb and say that they are not going to be in my top five teams to watch this season.